Welcome back. Well, after the United States demanded of Israel a ceasefire and abstained from the UN vote, Benjamin Netanyahu cancelled his trip to Washington. But White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre said on Wednesday that the Israeli Prime Minister had agreed to reschedule the meeting dedicated to Rafah. And meanwhile, the offensive in Rafah appears to be stalling. Let's bring in now a special guest, award-winning Israeli-Arab journalist, lecturer and documentary filmmaker Khaled Abu Toameh. Welcome to this program and to Australia. Great to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Now, you know, a lot of people don't realise that actually 20% of the population in Israel are Israeli Arabs. They're not Jews. What's the Israeli Arab community's general reaction and consensus to Israel's war on Hamas?
Well, it's not... I mean, the question is not whether how we respond to Israel's war on Hamas, it's how do we respond to the Hamas attack on Israel? And the vast majority of us, the Arabs inside Israel, are opposed to it. We've condemned it. We haven't engaged in any violence against Israel. We have spoken out against it on numerous occasions. Now, why are we opposed to it? Because no one can identify with such atrocities that happened on October 7th. It goes against our values, it goes against our religion. The vast majority of us, the Arabs inside Israel, are Muslim. This is not what Islam taught us. So for that reason, number one, we could not identify with such atrocities. And number two, many Arabs fell victim to that attack. 21 Arab Muslims were killed by Hamas on that day. Five or six other Muslims were kidnapped by Hamas into Gaza, and some of them are still in Gaza.
So being held hostage.
Yes, being held hostage. And for that reason, we, the Arabs in Israel, have come out against it. We have condemned it, and we cannot accept something like this.
And so you've condemned the attacks by Hamas. Does that then mean that you agree with Israel's war on Hamas in Gaza?
We understand why Israel went to war. I mean, Israel has a right to defend itself. Israel has a right to respond to that attack, and Israel has a right to go and seek the release of the hostages. So we understand that, and our concern as the is the concern of many people over there is for the civilians who are being killed in Gaza. We would like to see Israel avoid such casualties. We have no problem if Israel wants to go after Hamas or after Islamic Jihad or after all these terrorists, but try to avoid harming the civilians. We also understand that it's very difficult to go to war in Gaza without harming civilians, because Gaza is a very small place. Hamas and Islamic Jihad are, first of all, they're not fighting in uniform. They're also fighting amongst the...
Just in regular clothes.
Yes, in regular clothes, number one. And number two, they're fighting from residential areas.
The death toll that's reported in Gaza is around 30,000 people. This is what we hear from the Hamas-run health ministry. Do you think that's accurate, that 30,000 civilians have been killed?
It's very hard to tell. I mean, this is the only source for this is the Hamas-controlled Ministry of Health. Now, you don't have foreign journalists in Gaza. And I, as a journalist, I used to go to Gaza until 2007. I cannot go there anymore because Hamas seized control over Gaza. So there is no way of verifying these figures that we're hearing about.
In terms of the sentiment among Palestinians, you know, you specialize in Palestinian affairs. Do the majority of Palestinians, you think, still support Hamas? Would they re-elect a Hamas government? Or are they starting to think that, well, actually, this government that we elected has not taken us in a good direction and is responsible for the devastation and the loss of life that they're now experiencing?
Again, it's very hard to tell because we don't have elections over there. My feeling is that Hamas remains very popular among many Palestinians. And it's not necessarily because they love Hamas. It's mostly because when anyone attacks Israel, Palestinians switch their support to that party or to that leader. So Hamas is popular not because it's Hamas, because it attacked Israel, because it inflicted pain on Israel, because it caused Israel such damage. Now, I believe that if you hold free and democratic elections tomorrow morning, Hamas will still win. For the reason I just mentioned, and for another reason, it's because the Palestinian Authority is not seen as a better alternative to Hamas.